You know, I think to myself, we live in a time in our world that is so negative, just everybody gets angry at the drop of a hat. You know what? It's time for us to bring light into darkness. Amen?
Amen.
It's time for us to be the joy that we want to see. And the only way we can do that is if we opt out of the negativity, whether it's on Facebook or whether it's in conversations. We have to make any difference. Let's change our community by being positive. Makes sense to me. How about you?
Can I just add, show up? Because that's what I've been seeing David do. On the 1st of October, he's been there literally every day working 15-hour days with us because he knows what it means to be the fragrance of Christ. And there's a picture of him, it's still up on the screen, but it was the best I could do. I can't catch David. It's like trying to follow the Iron Man around a building. I keep looking for the cape. But I found a picture of him doing what he's been doing, and that's been working when no one else is watching. And I just want to encourage you to do the same thing, because every one of you in this room today is bringing a kingdom influence into our county. And I want to encourage you to just do three things in the minute that I have left. Be in the Word of God every day. There is a war going on. The Bible teaches us in Ephesians 6 that our battle is not against people, it is a spiritual battle. And the enemy knows if you're not in the Word, that your spiritual lives will grow dim and your influence will be weakened. I want to encourage you to live a life of integrity and let the love of God influence every area of your life. And finally, I want to encourage you to speak the truth boldly. You have the hope and change inside of you that an entire nation has been searching for the last 15 years, because you have Jesus. And that is the answer that we need in this nation. We'll never make America great again apart from the love and saving grace of Jesus. But God values life. And every life in this room is important to God, and every life in the county matters to God. And if we're going to have an impact on the lives of those around us, then our lives need to speak in private what they speak in public. That means that when no one else is watching, we are listening to and following to and crying out to the living God, the one who makes the lame boys walk again and who heals counties and cities and nations. That when a student is fully trained, he'll be like his teacher. This is the reason my husband and I have been pouring into families for the last 15 years, telling them, parents, teachers, educators, wake up. The Bible says that your children will be an awful lot like you. And that means that we need to be men and women of integrity. My name is Heidi St. John, and I'm here today representing on behalf of David and Donna Madore. David is the owner of U.S. Digital and one of the founders of the U.S. Digital Outreach Center, where my husband and I were privileged to have our nonprofit organization from the Clinton family for 5 years. David and his team were inspired by a simple question in the Bible out of Exodus 4, verse 2, what is in your hand? The simple staff in Moses' hand became an instrument that God used to part the Red Sea. And I want to ask you this morning, since I'm privileged and humbled to speak in front of so many leaders, what is in your hand? Because that inspiration, coupled with the will of God and God's providence and hard work, has created a blessing through the U.S. Digital Outreach that is reaching hundreds of thousands of people. The Outreach Center opened its doors in 2008, and since then they have provided the infrastructure for a variety of, quote, small ministries that are having a tremendous impact for the Lord around the world. Over 196 countries, 205,000 children, and over 200,000 adults have been impacted by these, quote, small ministries that are working in harmony with each other in the U.S. Digital Outreach Center.
And you've been sitting here for a while, you've had a nice breakfast, and some of you are already sleepy and we haven't even hardly started. So I'm going to give you 30 seconds. That's it, 30 seconds. This is your obedience test. I want you to stand up. I want you to shake hands with one or two people and tell them they look really good for this early morning. Stand up right now. Or perhaps your limitations or your aspirations are as limited as one guy asked what he wanted to make out of his life, and he said, I just want somebody to make me a sandwich. What do you make out of your life? How are you using the time and the talent and the resources you have to make a difference in that world around us of people who aren't singing much anymore? What are we making out of our lives? All those things we talked about can be good things, but is that it? I would suggest that's not it. Because I think what we really want as human beings, what we really want, what we really need, what we crave for is not just for those things. But I believe what really fulfills us is when we can make a difference by passing through this life. So that we can lay our head on our pillow for the last time and say that something good happened because we were around. We want to make a difference. Now, like many things in life, that truth is actually pretty simple. But it's not easy. It's simple to get up here. It's not easy to do out there, right? And yet, if I read my scriptures right, it seems pretty simple. Like this one, out of Micah. He said, but he's already made it plain how to live and what to do, what God is looking for in men and women. It's quite simple. Do what is fair and just for your neighbor. Be compassionate and loyal in your love. And don't take yourself too seriously. Take God seriously. That's simple, but not easy. But here they are. Seven keys. There could be 37 keys. But seven keys that will make a difference in our community. One, you have to continue to open our eyes, our ears, and our hearts. Second, we have to make an honest investment of our financial and material resources. Third, we have to offer the personal gift of our time and energy. Fourth, we have to have an inclusive love for people of all races, cultures, and status. Fifth, we have to have courage to face opposition and obstacles. Sixth, we have to earn the respect through demonstrated integrity. And seventh, we have to seize the power of collective or collaborative effort. I learned as a kid, my parents taught me early, a little song that said, God owns the cattle on a thousand hills and the wealth in every mine. As an adult, I figured out, yes, God owns the cattle on a thousand hills and the wealth of every mine, and he puts it in our checking accounts. And it's for us to use. Financial stewardship is the result of the choices that we make with what he's given to us. When those choices are made wisely, amazing things happen that can make a difference in our community. When they're not, things don't happen. To make a difference in somebody else's life. Like the man who was kind of miserly his whole life. Made money, had a good amount, but didn't use it at all for his family, enjoyed his family, he just saved it all. He was a miser. And shortly before he died, he instructed his wife to take all of his resources, all of his money, put it in a shoebox, and put it in his casket, because he was going to take it with him. Now his wife was so beat down from over the years of penny pinching that she agreed. And so the man dies. At the funeral, just before the guy comes to close the lid, his wife dutifully comes up with a shoebox, sticks it in the coffin, closes the door, goes back to her seat. When the funeral's over, one of her friends comes up to her and said, you didn't really put all that money in the coffin, did you? And she said, oh no, I promised him I would. So I took all the money, took it to the bank, deposited it, and then I wrote him a check for the full. Can't get away with just giving a little bit of time and say that's quality time. It doesn't work that way. Time is the commodity of any good relationship. Giving our time to something takes away time from something else. That's just the way it works because we have a limited supply. Therefore, a decision needs to be made on how we're going to use our time and use it wisely. I would suggest if we're really going to make a difference in our community, one of the choices we're going to have to make is to offer the personal gift of our time and energy. Right? There's people
who are Christians, who struggle with that for all. That's a bunch of people who don't believe like us.
That's right.
For all. I don't see it as a challenge at all. We don't have to change who we are to be inclusive. We can truly love people and still disagree with them. Jesus proved that as he spoke to the woman at the well or Zacchaeus, the tax collector. He was the demonstration of love without compromise. So if we're going to be Christ-like in our community, if we're going to make a difference to the world around us, we're going to have to make the choice to love people of all races and cultures and status, even those we disagree with. Fifth, we need to have the courage to face opposition and obstacles. Rarely is something significant accomplished without having to go through it. Do you understand what I mean?
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now I am found. To feel.